Hello everyone, this is Suyesh here, and now in this video we'll be continuing in the section of our large intestine anatomy. Okay, this is a sixth video. Okay, watch my previous videos on each of the part of our large intestine. So this is the last part of our large intestine, as we have rectum. Okay, so rectum is included in large intestine. So we'll be discussing the anatomy of rectum, and the rectum video will be in the two parts. Okay, in the first video we'll be discuss some of the anatomy, and the next video we'll be discussing the relations and interior structures of the rectum. Okay, the layers of internal layers of the rectum. Okay, so now let's discuss first of all the basic anatomy, from where it extends and what is the length. Okay, what are the curvatures? So that we will be seeing in this video. Clear? So now first of all, the as you know, the rectum is actually the distal part of our large intestine. This you know, distal part of large intestine. This is the last and the most distal part, and it is continuous with the which part of large intestine? It is continuous with the sigmoid column. Okay, so from the upper side, from the proximal region of rectum, it is continuous with sigmoid colon. Okay, and which is a part of large intestine, and in the distal part of the rectum, it is continuous with anal canal. Okay, so sigmoid colon and present, you can say in simple language that it is present between sigmoid colon and anal canal. Okay, so in the lower part or in the distal part, it is continuous with anal canal, and in the proximal part, it is continuous with the sigmoid colon. Clear this much? And if we compare with the large intestine, some cardinal features we have discussed in the first video. So as we know that the large intestine is having three important cardinal features, like we have tenia coli muscles, and we have the omental appendages. Okay, and circulations, hostra coli. So all these three structures, which are the distinguishing features of the large intestines, are not present in this rectum. So we don't see cardinal features of large intestine in this rectum. Okay, intestine, we don't see cardinal intestine in rectum. Okay, so this is one of the difference, or you can say one of the most important point. Okay, and if from the Latin, if we consider the meaning of the rectum, so rectum meaning is actually straight from Latin, but it is not straight. Okay, it is not straight, but in quadrupeds, like in the quadrupeds species, the rectum is straight, but in case of the humans, it is not straight. Okay, but the meaning is straight from Latin. Okay, so this is just extra information. Okay, now where is the location of this rectum? So from the location, you can say it is actually present on the posterior part of lesser pelvis. Posterior part of lesser pelvis. Okay, in the posterior section, lesser pelvis, and in with respect to the that is male and female, you can say it is in the male, it is present on the posterior side of our urinary bladder. Okay, a urinary bladder, and in the case of female, it is present on the posterior side of the uterus. Okay, male posterior to urinary bladder, and female posterior to uterus. Okay, and if we say with respect to the anterior relation, means on the posterior side of rectum, what is present? So the rectum is actually located in the concavity of the sacrum and coccyx. Okay, so it is also located in the concavity of sacrum and coccyx. Okay, so the meaning is that you can see in this diagram, this is actually the sagittal section. Okay, this orange one is actually your rectum. So you can see that these are actually your S3 vertebra, S2, there is S4 and S5 and coccyx. So it is actually beginning at the level of your S3 vertebra. You can say rectosigmoid junction is actually present. So just consider here it will be your sigmoid colon. From here it will be just coming. Okay, and this will be your descending colon. So you can see this junction is actually here, your rectosigmoid junction. It is present on which level? S3 vertebra level. Okay, so S3 vertebra is actually the sign of the level of our rectosigmoid junction. Okay, so we can say rectum is beginning from the level of your S3 vertebra. So you can see it is continuing downward from S3 till the coccygeus. So it is present anteriorly to sacrum, full that is the lower part of sacrum, you can say S3, S4, S5, and full coccyx. Clear? So the meaning is that it is present in the concavity. So sacrum takes a concavity in the posterior side. So in that concavity, you can see the rectum is present. So meaning of explaining is that it is present in the concavity of the sacrum. Clear this much? Now the measurement, if we go for the measurement, that is what is the length, you can say. The length is around 12 centimeter, okay, and 5 inches. And if we consider a diameter, so in the upper part, it is continuous sigmoid colon, so diameter will be large, that is around 4 centimeter. 4 centimeter in upper part, okay. And in lower part, this rectum actually forms an ampulla here, which is called as rectal ampulla, okay, where your feces are actually stored, okay, from where the actually reflexes are given to the anal canal, and from that you defecate, okay. So in the ampulla, most of the feces are present. So it is more dilated than the upper part, okay. So the difference is that in the anal, that is rectal ampulla, more wide, okay, lower part it is present. So you can see this part is actually your rectal ampulla, okay, and here will be your anorectal junction between your anal canal and rectum, okay. So here you can consider it is your rectal ampulla, the dilated part of the rectum, the most dilated part of the rectum. Clear this much? Now if we see the relate with the how the pathway of the rectum, how it takes a downward or vertical, okay. So in the upper part is actually first of all taking the concavity, okay, going backward somewhat and downward, and in the middle one third part it is now going downward only, vertically it is going downward. Now when it is coming to the lower one third part, now it is going somewhat downward and forward. So this is an angle which the rectum is taking, okay. So this angle is actually a curvature here, which is called as anorectal curvature, you can say, or perineal curvature. We will discuss later, okay, after a few minutes. So this is actually the curve which is taking, that is why it is called as is going forward and downward. But in the upper side, it was going first of all backward, downward it is coming, it is similar, and the middle part is only going downward vertically, and the lower part it is somewhat going forward, and then taking the angle there, which is called as anorectal angle. Here, this angle which is made by the rectum is called as anorectal angle, okay. And this curve is called as perineal curvature, or you can say anorectal curvature, which we'll discuss after a few minutes. Clear this much? Now, measurement we have done, the pathway we have seen, okay. And rectum actually goes somewhat about level of coccyx, or you can say 2 to 3 centimeter below the coccyx, where you can find the anorectal junction, okay. So this is the ending of the extension of the rectum from the level of S3 vertebra till the coccyx, or you can say somewhat little below the coccyx, around 2 to 3 centimeter. So this is the extension for the rectum. Clear this much? Now let's move on to the curvatures, okay, curvatures which I told you we will discussing. So these are the two diagrams for the curvatures. So we have actually two curvatures in the section of our rectum. First is called as anterior posterior curvature. Clear? And second is called as lateral curvature. Okay? So we'll be dividing the curvature into two parts, that is anterior posterior curvature and lateral curvature. So in anterior posterior curvature, we have further two curvatures, the sacral curvature and perineal curvature or anorectal curvature. Anorectal. Clear? And in lateral curvature, we have upper, middle, and lower. Okay? So these are the actually full curvatures of the, or flexures of rectum, you can say. Flexures also, you can say. Flexures of rectum. Clear? So these are actually the curvatures. So these are the diagram, and this is a diagram for anterior posterior curvature, okay. So this one diagram is anterior posterior, this is for the lateral curvature. Clear? So let's relate the sacral curvature first of all. So as I told you, the sacrum concavity. So the rectum, in the upper part, the rectum is present in the sacrum concavity. You can say around the level of your S3 and S4 vertebra. So you can see this curvature, this concavity in the sacrum. Okay. So this is called as sacral curvature. Okay, on the anterior posterior aspect. Okay. Now the second curvature in this is the perineal curvature. You can see this angle. Okay, so this is the convexity. Okay, convexity, and this angle is actually, which the angle is making is called as anorectal angle, and the curvature which is forming is called as anorectal curvature or perineal curvature. Perineal curvature. Clear? So this curvature is actually, or this round is actually held by the part of levator any muscle, which is called as puborectalis. Okay, so puborectalis is a part which will be just consider this is your pubic symphysis cut structure. So here just consider there will be your pubic symphysis like this. Okay, so it will be just held by this this curvature will be just held by this sling of puborectalis, which is the part of levator any muscle like this. Okay, so this angle is actually held by this sling of puborectalis. So this black one is actually your puborectalis muscle, you can say, or sling, or part of levator any muscle. Okay, so this is held by the puborectalis sling. Clear? So this was the anterior posterior curvature. We have the two curvature, and it is present on the level of your coccygeus, coccyx, and S5 sacrum. Now we have the lateral curvatures, upper and middle and lower. So upper is, we have the two curvatures, the upper and lower, to the right side of convexity. Okay, so upper, this one is actually your upper curvature. So it is right to the convexity of the rectum. Okay, and this is lower curvature. Okay, and this, you can see, this is convexity on the left side. Okay, so these are the convexity on the right side. So these lower ones are on the right convexity, and it middle is having a left convexity. Okay, so this is the difference. So this is actually your middle curvature. Clear? So these are the three curvature, and out of which the middle is more prominent. Okay, more prominent curvature. Clear? So these are the five curvatures in which we have anterior, posterior, and lateral curvature. Now let's discuss the relations of peritoneal relations in the different levels of the rectum. We have three levels: upper, middle, and lower. So in the section of our upper, just consider this is your upper part. Okay, so this is actually covered from all the sides. All the sides means from the anterior sides and from the sides. So this is actually a peritoneal covering, this red one. Okay, so the upper part covered by sides and on anterior. So that is why it forms a mesentery, which is called as mesorectum. So mesorectum is actually present on the upper one third part of the rectum. Now comes the middle. So like this will be the middle cross section, and peritoneum will be just like this only, from one side, that is from anterior side covered. Okay, and now next comes your lower third part. So this is the lower third part, which will not be covered with any peritoneum. So devoid of peritoneum, extraperitoneal. Okay, devoid of peritoneum. So this was the peritoneal relations. Okay, so I think this is the first video of rectum. Next video we'll be discussing the relations, actually what is present posterior, anterior, in different level of the part. That is, on the upper part there will be different relation, on the middle aspect there will be some other structures on the posterior, anterior side, and lower also. So that we'll be discussing in the next video in detail, and the internal structure of the rectum also. I think this is the basic anatomy of the rectum. So if you like the video, do share and subscribe the channel.